All right, hello there. Welcome to another session of the Queen's News Update. This week, we're going to lead off with some urgent news regarding Con Edison, and I actually want to thank my dad for making me well aware of this, because I was trying to find last week's digital edition of The Courier, but they've already taken it down, and I can't archive it, so instead, I've had to do my own research. I've had to research the New York State Senate. I had to research, honestly, other things, including the Governor Cuomo's phone number, believe it or not. He actually has a phone number up in Albany where you can complain to him. But I did leave a voicemail. I don't know if it was clear enough to him, but I'm going to do an outreach here on YouTube regarding Con Edison. And that's why I'm leading off with the headline, Con Edison potentially raising rates in 2020. All right, so that's what I am leading off with. It's going to say Con Edison looking to raise gas rates in 2020. That should be the headline we're going to go with for this session. But we're also going to read 5 articles from The Courier. It's a short edition this week because of the Thanksgiving holiday. And also, my computer has been out of commission this week because I did a video back on Wednesday explaining why I had to install Linux on my computer, which didn't end up the way it was supposed to, but I'm back on Windows 10. That's the main thing. As long as I'm on Windows 10 recording this video, that's all that matters to me right now. So, without more blabbering, let's lead off with this urgent matter from the AARP. Now, they took out in page last week's Queen's Courier. If you can find last week's edition from the 21st, it was from Beth Finkel, who represents the AARP. So I'm gonna have to find a way to scan this document, or I don't know, but I'll read it. Because eventually I got to get rid of this paper and maybe this will just be archived. But let's talk about an article and I'll read it from the paper last week. So it says, do you know that Con Edison is on the verge of raising the price you pay for delivery of gas to heat your home by 40%? So again, this is not only for Queens, but this is for the whole city of New York. So that's why I'm specifically doing it in the Queens News Update. Because again, Queens has the largest senior population in all of the city of New York. So that's another reason why this is specific for the borough of Queens. So that way, everybody who's 65 and older can be made aware of this. But anyhow, let's continue. So again, Con Edison's looking to raise the delivery of gas rates to 40%. Don't be surprised if you haven't heard the proposal hasn't gotten much notice. But if you're outraged, you're not alone. The AARP is outraged too. And we're letting state utility regulators and Governor Andrew Cuomo know about this. The 40% in cost of delivering gas used for heating is just one of a proposal that would pull $1.2 billion more out of Con Edison's customers' pockets over the next 3 years starting in January. So again, that's why I'm leading off with that headline. The deal proposed by the company and the staff of the Utility Regulating State Public Service Commission, PSC, would also raise the cost of delivering cooking gas by 25% and electricity by 15%. So, it says it right here. Look on the screen right now. Con Edison and the staff of the Department of Public Service have proposed a rate in New York State and New York City that would increase the average customer electric delivery bill by 15%. Also, I forgot to mention, this impacts Westchester. I forgot to mention, Con Edison served by Westchester. So don't forget about that. So if you're in Westchester County, you need to pay attention to this too, because you're going to get affected. So I just forgot to mention that. This is a painful prospect for New Yorkers who already pay some of the highest utility rates in the nation. So I'm going to leave the article, the link to, for this submission that you can pretty much say, listen, I'm a Con Edison customer. We don't want this to happen. So again, I have called the governor's office, but I'll leave that in the description below. I'll read it in the article as well. Because You do want to leave the governor a voicemail or speak to somebody in his staff regarding a bill. I will get to the bill in just a second if you do get a hold of somebody or even a weird miracle happens that maybe you might bump into the governor and you might talk to him about a specific bill, because out of all the antics in this state, this is what I'm worried about. It's not just my dad, but again, I just said this. I live in a borough. Out of all the five boroughs, Queens has the largest senior population. So this is an insult to them. All right? 65 and older, I'm talking about. So, let's continue. AARP is urging the PSC and New York Governor Andrew Cuomo to reject this unconsiderable proposal, which would add unreasonably higher costs to the overburdened Con Edison customers in New York City and Westchester County, don't forget Westchester County, who already pay among the highest energy delivery rates in the nation. All right? This hike would especially hurt millions of moderate and low-income customers who struggle to pay their utility bills month in and month out. And Con Edison doesn't have a great track record on that front. And I have looked this up. They did the same thing in 2013 where they raised rates. Same thing. So they did this 6 years ago. And now, 7 years later, starting in January, which would be in 2020, they're potentially going to do this. So, again, just a complete outrage. The company's escalated compliant rate complaints the utility can't resolve with the customer was more than double of that of any other major electric, gas, and utility company in New York State over the last 5 years. There's nothing in this proposal requesting Con Edison to bring its escalated complaint rate down to the statewide average. Since 2014, about 300,000 residential Con Ed customers, on average, have been at least 60 days late paying their utility bills. That's about 10% of all customers. Around 30% of low-income customers, an average of 127,263, had areas of more than 60 days from January 1st, 2018 to March of this year, owing an average of $790. Another 23,501 elderly, blind, or disabled customers were behind at least 60 days as of March 6th of this year. That's too many New Yorkers who can't pay their utility bills. What's more, the proposal would force Con Edison ratepayers to cover $39 million for subsidizing electric vehicle charging stations. So, I find this to be a waste of money. $39 million just to for electric charging? That could go into bus maintenance. Queens Village Bus Depot needs that money right now more than electric charging stations. The Orion 7 old gens need that money right now. My God, I'm so sorry to get passionate about that, but seriously, it's hundreds of thousands of dollars to get each Orion 7 old gen maintained right now. This money should go into looking on preventing overheating for when summer comes next year and we need air conditioning on the Orion 7 old gens. See, that's what I could do with $39 million right now. Ridiculous, you know? Proposal ignores the PSC's obligation to ensure that utility rates are just and reasonable. Again, seriously, this is one of the most taxed states in the nation, and this is the excuse they give us, and especially how the president got rid of our SALT deduction back in 2017. So keep that in mind. Okay, the increases in the proposals far exceeded the inflation rate, not only for the previous 3 years, but projected inflation for the next three. Projected decreases in the cost of energy itself may mask these double-digit delivery rate increases. So the increases in total bills, which combine the price of energy and the cost to deliver it to energy and the cost to deliver it to consumers' homes, may seem reasonable. But when energy prices increase, delivery rates won't decrease and consumers will feel the price in a big way. All of this points to need for better consumer protection in New York, which is among the minority of states lacking an independent utility consumer advocate. So this is where the New York State Senate comes in. And I'll get to this bill in just a second. So I'll put it up on the screen right now so you all can understand what this is about. Besides rejecting this unreasonable Con Edison rate hike, Governor Cuomo could give New York utility customers, such as an independent advocate, simply by signing Bill, New York State Senate Bill, S4399A-19, which was passed back on, I have a date, I'm going to make sure here, I thought I had a date. Here we go. Which was approved on June 17th of this year. There we go. So again, we have the proof that it was passed in both the New York State Assembly, and this was also passed in the New York State Senate. And I'm assuming that Nicole Malliotakis and Nilin Rozic, and David Reprin, three people who I really care about in the Assembly, got this done. Because if they didn't, they voted nay, I would be upset. I have to look into that. But I'm sure they voted yay. Okay. The playing field needs leveling. Consumers pay over $10 million annually for Con Ed and other utilities to hire lawyers, economists, and experts to push for higher rates. So pretty much this advocate could form a team and legally challenge this and say, stop it, you're not allowed to do this, all right? We're representing New York State, and we're on behalf of, and this individual would be on behalf of the governor of New York State. So let's look at the actions right now, folks. Let's look at this, if we can find a specific timeline here. I don't know how this would work out. You see if it's, here we go. Finance Committee. Not what I'm looking for. Here we go. So I think this is the specifics, unless maybe I'm wrong here. I don't know. But I saw something earlier that said, well, we have other people who got involved. So I do apologize if I can't find anything at the moment regarding the status. Here's the status. So it says past Senate, past Assembly. So what upsets me here is why hasn't this been delivered to Governor Cuomo? That's what I left the voicemail for. And that's what I'll get to the voicemail in just a second. All right, so here we go. This bill would give consumers their own advocate to hire expert witnesses to counter the deep pockets from other parties and challenge unfair rate hikes in the courts. So this is interesting. Consumers would have an advocate to, again, stop this. Okay, Con Edison proposal does increase funding for the utility's low-income programming and includes an agreement with the company to refrain from shutting off customers' power for non-payment during extreme heat. But it doesn't do enough to achieve just and reasonable utility rates. So, you can give a call. There's two phone numbers. AARP has a phone number. The first is 844-254-6881. And there's also another phone number. I believe this is the governor's office, if I'm wrong or not. But here's another number. 844-586-9562. So again, this link, and I'll have the phone numbers in the description below so you all can get involved. Because again, this is going to be a real burden to people in New York City and Westchester County. Because still, I just feel that Con Edison's the one that is trying to screw everybody and just say, well, sorry, this is what we want. And, you know, remember what happened back in July with the blackout in Manhattan? The governor even said that necessarily Con Edison doesn't have to be the utility here. So if they do something outrageous like this, and we can't get an advocate, and the governor's cold-hearted and just vetoes this bill, somebody needs to be sued. That's all I'm going to say. I don't know who would deal with this, but, you know, the New York State Attorney General may even have to get involved. I would hope Letitia James would, but I doubt it. I doubt it. And speaking of the governor, let's talk about how he screwed everybody in Queens not expanding the Moorer Parkway hiking trail. Let's get into that. So, the governor vetoed a bill back on Monday that would commission a study aimed at expanding. Now look, here's an epic fail. It's just duh. How do you put duh twice in the same sentence? My goodness. Okay, here we go. The current hiking trail, it currently runs from 210th Street to Winchester Boulevard in the Oakland Garden section of Bayside. This extension would have connected the Queens portion of the trail to a portion of the Moorer Parkway in Nassau County, which is being in the process of being redeveloped. The project is a result of an effort to connect the surveying portions of the parkway with new trails and form a trail that would extend to Weston Long Island. Now, this is what I'm happy with John Liu. Because remember, when we went to Casino Park, and when we did that video, the Ferrero Dome, at the time, was passed by then City Councilman John Liu. So, I want to give a big round of applause here to John Liu, my state senator, for actually having some common sense here, trying to get this done, and looking out for us. I gotta admit, I don't know if Vicky Palladino would have done this. I don't know. I don't know if she would have. Sorry to call her out, but this is a bipartisan issue. This is something that would have benefited me and other people who wanted to go on a longer hike. All right, I like that hiking trail. I've shown you it all on this channel. Still, this is just like the Pine Barrens in Suffolk County. The governor double-crossed Suffolk. And now, he's double-crossing me here in Queens. Can't make this stuff up. Alright, there was no funding. What funding? What funding? That's another thing. If $39 million can't go into maintenance for the Orion 7 old gens, then why can't we just put $39 million for this? Unbelievable. This state just doesn't know how to use money because the governor has an egotistical point of view. There's so much you can do, not just with this, but again, what about preserving the Pine Barrens in Suffolk? All right? You can't just get rid of preserved land. That's a whole different story. So now he says, oh, sorry. I'm not going to put my money where my mouth is. I'm not going to fund an extension for a hiking trail. You know? And keeping in mind, this is the state getting involved because Nassau County plays a role in this too. You can't make this stuff up. I don't even want to read the letter. But the quote says, in effect, the bill would call for an environmental impact study statement for a project that is not currently contemplated by Office of Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation, and for which there are no funds. Cuomo added he supports the laudable intent of the bill and will urge sponsors to push for project. Still, I don't know what else we're going to do here, but please, folks, if you care about this, please call John Liu, because I know I have to speak with him about the housing discrimination, because I'm thinking of going to it in Mineola, because I'm going to ask his office if he is going to attend the housing discrimination thing, because if he's going to care equally about Long Island, even though he represents me here in Fresh Meadows, I need to be fair with him. I know it sounds crazy, but you know how I have a feud with this guy. He could squash this beef with me. He's so far making a good sign by advocating for my interest to get a hiking trail that I really want. If he can advocate for people in Long Island for housing discrimination, then it's a good step. Very good step. And we'll get to that another time, because I don't even want to get into it in this video. All right, so let's talk about Queensborough president here. They want to increase community board diversity. So that's interesting. All right. So they had a candidate form. Six candidates each took the opportunity to explain how their vision for the office would go further than that of the district attorney-elect. Okay. So the candidates complained that the current borough president, Melinda Katz, who will be the Queen's district attorney in January, did not do enough to make sure her community boards are diverse enough to represent the borough. Now, again, my issue is there are no Republicans running. All right, that's the problem. But here's the thing with me that people have wanted me to do in my city council district is that if there's no Republican running, I may have to challenge Roy Lantzman in 2021. I'll get to that when that time comes, but people at Northwell have been encouraging me to do that. So they say, don't run for mayor. You're going to waste your time. You have a better chance of possibly winning a city council seat. So I'd rather be in the city council if I had to pick somewhere where I want to be right now. All right. So there's going to be a special election, and then we go to another headache in 2021. But still, I agree, there should be more diversity. So I'm not going to get more into this, but it makes complete sense to me. So now we're going to get into some stories that won't give me headaches. And we'll wrap up this video. So first story. Senior pedestrian struck in fatal Murray Hill collision. Cops are investigating a motor vehicle collision that resulted in the death of an 80-year-old pedestrian in Murray Hill last week. Police responded to a 911 call regarding a pedestrian struck at the intersection of 41st Avenue and Murray Street at approximately 12:35 p.m. on November 22nd. Upon arriving at the scene, officers discovered 80-year-old Soon Okehan Alevitown laying on the road with trauma to his body. EMS transported Han to New York Presbyterian Hospital of Queens, where she was pronounced dead. An investigation conducted by the New York Police Department Highway District Collision Investigation Squad determined that a 61-year-old man was driving a 2015 Honda Civic and traveling westbound on 41st Avenue before coming to a stop for the stop sign at the intersection of Murray Street. When the motorist drove through the intersection, he struck Han, who was crossing 41st Avenue and south to north in the vicinity of the marked West crosswalk, according to authorities. Upon impact, Khan was knocked to the road before being struck again by the vehicle. The vehicle operator remained at the scene, was not injured. No arrest. Investigation remains ongoing. Now we're going to go back to a story that we've talked about on this channel regarding our infrastructure. So the first headline for infrastructure news goes back to the Long Island City Queens Library. Now, we have a lawsuit here. A Long Island City resident has sued the Queens Public Library for inaccessibility issues at Hunter's Point. So again, we've talked about this. Okay. So let's go into some of the specifics. All right, here we go. See, there's a lawsuit plaintiff Tanya Jackson, City for Independence for Disabled New York. They claim that there's no elevator, it sounds like. You have to rely on stairs. So, there's three levels that do not have an elevator. Alright, the children's section contains multi-level wooden lounging and a small group meeting space inaccessible to children and caregivers with mobile disabilities. So that's ridiculous, you know? I mean, I'm glad somebody's taking action on it, but they're taking the matter very seriously, according to a spokeswoman, Elizabeth D. Bourbon. So, let's hope that this lawsuit produces results, because if you are having an inaccessibility issue at this branch where you don't have an elevator, that's a problem. And lastly, let's go to Councilman Jimmy Van Bramer. So let's talk about 16 Oaks Park in Long Island City. Let's get into this. A tiny park in Long Island City will get a $1.3 million makeover, City Councilman Jimmy Van Bramer announced back on Monday. 16 Oaks Grove Park, a triangular space dominated by 16 oak trees between 21st Street and 14th Street, will undergo numerous renovations. So, Councilman Van Bramer said, "This is a beautiful space that is essentially empty. We can add appropriate benches and greenery to beautify this space for those who live around this park. Since the approval of the New York City budget back in June, we have made a devoted effort in improving our public spaces throughout Queens. The renovation provides our residents with a place that can be proud to visit and enjoy with families and friends alike." 16 Oak Groves Park is a popular with the residents of the Ravens Road houses just a block away. So, this is very good that he's looking into this. Because, major renovation. That's good for the infrastructure. Very positive way to wrap up the Queens News update for this weekend. So again, it is a short, abbreviated version because of Thanksgiving. There was a lot of crime reported, believe it or not, in Ridgewood and Middle Village this week. But I'm like, do I really want to get into that? No. So that's why we're making it brief. And again, you know, my computer's been on the fritz. But again, I'm glad I'm back online. So thank you all for watching. Hopefully next week we'll go back to regular normal news. Thankfully there will be no holiday that will get everything involved here. So the next one, please take care.